मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, होप यू ऑल आर फाइन एंड सेफ। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू टॉक अबाउट सम डेली हैबिट्स, दैट इज न्यूट्रिशियस फूड, पर्सनल हाइजीन, एक्सरसाइज, परस्यूट ऑफ हॉबी। इट लीड्स टू एक्सेलेंट हेल्थ एंड गुड पर्सनल डेवलपमेंट। इट इज नेसेसरी दैट वी ऑल शुड बी अलर्ट अबाउट हेल्थ एंड हाइजीन। सो स्टूडेंट, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी साइंस 2 लेसन नंबर 9 सोशल हेल्थ। इन दैट वी विल स्टडी अबाउट सोशल हेल्थ, फैक्टर अफेक्टिंग सोशल हेल्थ एंड स्ट्रेस मैनेजमेंट। आवर एल्डर्स ऑलवेज इंस्ट्रक्ट यू टू गेट आउट ऑफ द होम, टू इंटरैक्ट विद रिलेटिव्स एंड अदर पीपल, प्ले आउटडोर गेम्स, बट नॉट टू स्पेंड टाइम कंटिन्यूसली विद टेलीविजन, फोन and internet. In this age of technology, our lifestyle has been changed to some extent. Each person is busy with own daily routine work and favorite jobs only. As a consequence, health of the person gets affected. We have studied the importance of physical health, cleanliness and staying healthy. However, the concept of the health does not end with it only. Just as we take care of our own health, we must make effort to ensure good health for all. In this lesson, we are going to study about what is actually meant by social health, factors affecting social health, and about factors distributing the social health. Let us start with this chapter. We all agree to this fact that the health of the entire community is important as one's own health. Good social health can be achieved through habits of cleanliness and good health on part of all individuals in a community. Social health is the ability of a person to establish relationship with other person. Let us study this concept in detail with the help of an activity. Observe the students of this class for a week and based on the observation, classify them into three groups: highly interactive, occasionally interactive, and non-interactive. There are total 30 students in this class. Among them, 5 students are highly interactive, 16 students are occasionally interactive, and 9 students are completely non-interactive. From this observation, we can conclude that maximum students of this class are interactive. The number of friends each of these students have vary, but along with these interactive students, this class also consists of students which are completely non-interactive, and these students have no friends. According to the definition of social health, maximum number of students of this class have the ability to establish relationship with other person. Is such situation in favor of social health? Ability to change one's own behavior according to changing social condition is an important characteristics of social health. Various factors affect social health. Among the same factor help to maintain good social health, while other contributes in disturbing the social health. Factors like strong personality, having large number of friends and relatives, proper use of time during loneliness and with peer group, trust in others, respect and acceptance for others are important for good social health. Whereas factors like pollution, superstition, addiction, etc. disturb the social health adversely. Let us study in detail about factors affecting social health. Food, clothing, shelter, water, and medicines are some of the basic needs of man. टू मेंटेन गुड सोशल हेल्थ इट इज एसेंशियल दैट दीज नीड्स आर सेटिस्फाइड. हाउएवर ड्यू टू इंक्रीजिंग पॉपुलेशन सेटिस्फाइंग दीज बेसिक नीड्स ऑफ मैन हैज ऑल्सो बिकम डिफिकल्ट. एज अ रिजल्ट प्रॉब्लम्स लाइक माल न्यूट्रिशन शॉर्टेज ऑफ फूड epidemics arise in the addiction to this. If residential areas, toilets and the surrounding are not kept clean, then this will lead to further deterioration of social health. In such conditions, it is very important to protect the masses and provide them with healthy environment. Thus, we can say that if our residential area, water, the toilets that we use can affect the social health, education and job opportunities decide the financial status of any person. A well-educated person has more job opportunity. The person becomes more confident. This enables a person to lead a happy personal and social life. Facilities like playground and gardens provide happy space for the children to play and for the aged people to exercise. Such facilities also helps to develop a passive change in the social health. Use of public transport facilities on large scale reduces traffic on road, helps to maintain air pollution and sound pollution. And thus, by this social health can be improved. Factors like social environment of the surrounding, social treatment and social physical condition of surrounding, political conditions or views and social safety are also dependent on each other. It also have a huge impact on a social health. After doing a brief study about factors affecting social health, let us now proceed to learn about which factors distribute the social health. Factors distributing the social health. There are various factors distributing the social health. Let us study about them one by one. First one, mental stress. Competition has increased in opportunities for education, employment and businesses. Due to increase in population, children are facing the problems of loneliness and mental stress due to reasons like nuclear family and parent staying outdoor due to jobs. In some families, discrimination between girls and boys is also witnessed. There are many binding on girls. In some families, boys are best stored with excessive freedom. Boys enjoy concession from household tasks, whereas girls have compulsion for the same with reason that girls should be used to all domestic chores. Not only this, but in some families, a boy is served with fresh food, while his sister has to fill her stomach by eating the leftover food. Discrimination between brothers and sisters in the same family on choice of learning medium is also observed most often. Boys of the family are sent to English medium school, whereas girls of the family are admissioned to Marathi medium school. In society too, adolescent girls have to unnecessarily face the problems like teasing and molestation. Due to such gender inequality, girls are facing problems of stress. Nowadays, you might have seen many advertisements about increasing awareness on avoiding the discrimination between girls and boys on television. This is one of the many efforts taken by the government to nurture our social health. Nowadays, everyone has to face the stress due to ever-increasing disorder, crime and violence. At the same time, people looking at this as fast as easy way to make money may become space goat and become part of search system. This is deadly effect of social illness. Let us now discuss about one more factor disturbing social health, that is addiction. In case of adolescent, peer group influence is much stronger. Adolescent always prefer the company of friends and follow their good or bad habits instead of following advice of parents and teachers. Due to peer either group pressure, symbol of high standard living, or as an imitation of elders. Adolescents in their early age try upon tobacco, cigarette, gutkha, alcoholic drinks, drugs, etc. Casual consumption of these deadly substances increases day by day. Due to such frequent consumption, they get used to such substances. And this leads to addiction to such deadly substances. Temporarily intoxicating drugs of plant's origin and some chemicals may permanently damage the human nervous system, muscle system, heart, etc. We have already studied in previous standard that long-term consumption of tobacco products may lead to mouth and lungs cancer. Smoke coming from tobacco products contain harmful products like pyridine, ammonia, carbon monoxide, nicotine, and sulfur dioxide. Due to inhalation of these compounds, healthy tissues of the lungs are affected. Tumors are formed. This can eventually lead to cancer. See this person inebriated with drugs or liquor loitering at dirty places. You must also have read the news about many deaths due to poisonous liquor in the newspaper. Can you tell why does it happen? Liquor is produced from alcohol obtaining through fermentation. However, if this process is performed in a wrong way, poisonous liquor is produced, which proves fatal for many at a time. Though the state of intoxicating temporarily in case of alcohol addicts, the ill effects of this addiction remains for long term. Due to alcoholism, efficiency of nervous system, especially brain and liver, hindered. Development of brain is also hindered in adolescence due to alcoholism and thereby the ability of memorizing and learning becomes slow. When a person becomes addicted to alcohol, the addict fails to think rationally. The person becomes restless and is not able to pay attention to anything else. Due to this, the person has to face the social, mental, and family problems along with physical illness. Such pitiful condition of most intelligent human being is not acceptable. Come, let us now proceed to next topic, diseases. Here an incident is shown. Observe this incident carefully. Here we can see that a leprosy patient is being ill-treated by a woman, due to which a patient have become sentimental. We should not have this kind of behavior towards any patient. In fact, in such conditions, we should be willing to listen and understand the patient. We should not be rude or disrespectful to patient. We should not humiliate the patient. On the contrary, we should treat the patient with lots of respect. Like the leprosy patient seen over here. People suffer from dreadful diseases like AIDS, टीबी एंड मेंटल डिसऑर्डर आर ऑल्सो मिसट्रीटेड. दे आर नॉट ऑफर्ड प्रॉपर रिक्वायर्ड केयर. लाइकवाइज इवन द ओल्ड पर्सन रिक्वायर देयर चिल्ड्रेन मोस्ट ड्यूरिंग देयर ओल्ड एज आर इग्नोर्ड बाय देयर किड्स. एट टाइम देयर चिल्ड्रेन हैव टू मूव अवे ड्यू टू देयर जॉब्स. दिस लीव्स नो चॉइस इन फ्रंट ऑफ द ओल्ड पर्सन्स बट टू लीव लोनली लाइफ. ऑल ऑफ दिस हैव लीड टू डे बाय डे इंक्रीज इन ओल्ड एज होम. सच फैक्टर्स ऑल्सो मे कॉज हार्म टू द सोशल हेल्थ. लेट अस नाउ प्रोसीड टू स्टडी अबाउट हाउ कम्युनिकेशन मीडिया एंड एक्सेसिव यूज ऑफ टेक्नोलॉजी कैन अफेक्ट द सोशल हेल्थ इन डिटेल. कम्युनिकेशन मीडिया एंड एक्सेसिव यूज ऑफ मॉडर्न टेक्नोलॉजी. टू स्टार्ट विद दिस टॉपिक फर्स्ट वी विल ऑब्जर्व टू सिचुएशंस शोन ओवर हियर. इन फर्स्ट सिचुएशन द मदर इज forcibly pulling the kid inside the house to study, while on the other hand in the second situation the mother is forcefully pushing the kid out of the house to play. Earlier mobile phones and communication media were not easily available to children, therefore they used to play outdoor games. However nowadays instead of outdoor games children are busy playing games on mobile phones and computers. Excessive use of modern communication technology is responsible for this situation. Let us understand this with the help of an activity. First, we will categorize the various tasks carried out by Sia during a daily routine under two groups. Time spent on health and time spent on other task, and then we will compare two groups. Out of 24 hours of her daily routine, Sia invests 14 hours on other task and only 10 hours on her health. Out of those 10 hours invested on her, Sia spent 1 hour 30 minutes for her health and hygiene. On the other hand, Sia spent 3 hours and 25 minutes watching television, playing games and Catholic on mobile phones and computer. Chatting on mobile phones and computer. Nowadays, excessive, unnecessary and irrational use of modern technology and communication media is becoming a sensitive issue. From the viewpoint of social health, persons spending the time with cell phones for several hours are usually unaware of the surrounding. This is also sort of addiction, which leads to endangering of social health. Various physical problems like tiredness, headache, insomnia, forgetfulness, tinnitus, joint pain and problems in vision many arises due to radiation of cell phones. More serious fact is those radiation penetrating the bones of children more effectively than the bones of adults. Children should not be given mobile phones to play. Person continuously using the computer and internet become solitary. Along they cannot establish harmonious relation with relatives and other members of the society. Habitually they become self-centered and thereby they may develop problems like autism and selfishness. They become less sensitive toward others. Chronic effects of such tendency is that they are not ready to help others in need, and hence They also do not get it in need. Do you recall the sudden closing of any cartoon serials for Indian origin being telecast on television? Children who watch the cartoon films may imitate the characters of those films, tendency and behavior of the children who plays game like virtual war and car race. Especially the ones where virtual accidents are deliberately brought about gradually becomes negative. They begin to develop a negative attitude. The mindset of the children playing such games become destructive. Some games available on cell phones and computer are time consuming. Lot of time of these children get wasted due to these games. The children lose concentration on some essential subjects. It also causes economic losses. Sometimes these games also prove to be fatal. One of the famous example of such game is the Blue Whale game. You might have definitely heard about this game. This game is played for a span of about 50 days, and the start of this game, the participant is instructed to draw a blue whale on the skin. At the last level of this game, the participant is ordered to commit suicide in order to win the game. If not done, threats are given to the participant. Overall, looking at this risk level, it high time to ask this question. Is it necessary to play such unsafe game at the cost of your life? What do you think? Along with some useful purpose, huge information available on internet is used for viewing some inappropriate videos too. However, there is a governmental regulation over such media. Website, movies and cartoon films inappropriate for children are banned by the government. Now, before proceeding to the next level, issues in the content to the excessive use of modern technology, let us observe this scene shown over here. Hey, what are you thinking? This is a very familiar scene, isn't it? Here a boy is standing in middle of a busy road and he is clicking a selfie. The boy is so engrossed in clicking selfie that he is completely unaware of speedy vehicle coming from behind. This irrational behavior of the boy can prove to be fatal. Nowadays, there is increased in the news of dead like drowning in ocean, falling in deep valley or under train during catching the cell phone selfies. Most of the time, a person including in selfie is not aware about the world around and the risk. This is called selfie-side. Nowadays, people choose to upload videos of road accident on WhatsApp, on Facebook instead of helping the victim. Such people are not sensitive toward others. You cannot expect any kind of help from such people. Person including in domestic violence, sending message to others before committing suicide, or those who send the video clips of suicidal act are mentally ill and they do so to gain the sympathy of others. Person including in such destructive and unnatural activities is usually under stress. Such activities are bursting of stress. Medical science has declared such activities as mental illness. Nowadays, video clips of parents threatening and hitting children, not studying as per the wish, or domestic helpers beating children are very common on social media. Thus, considering all these incidents, we should make constructive use of communication. media like television, phone and internet for essential needs and for entertainment only. Do not go into the clutches by spending hours with these communication media. Let us now study the next part of the lesson, that is cybercrime. Nowadays, we read a lot of about cybercrime in the newspaper. There are many examples of cybercrime. The incidents shown over here are few examples of cybercrime. Let us educate ourselves about cybercrime. Consumers are deceived by showing superior items on website but actually selling the items of either inferior quality or impaired ones. Bank transactions are done by using PIN without the knowledge of consumers. Confidential information about government institute and companies is obtained from internet with the help of computer program or other ideas, and the information obtained is misused. This is called as hacking of information. To avoid such incidents, bank continuously spread a message on mobile phones about not to disclose the Aadhaar, PAN, credit, debit card numbers and the other personal information if demanded by any person. Along with this, to avoid transactions by scammers, bank also instruct that consumer to not to disclose their PIN to anyone while withdrawing cash from ATM machine or purchasing through card payments. Nowadays, crimes like opening a fake account on Facebook and displaying false information and thereby teasing the girls or exploiting them financially have become so frequent. To avoid such circumstances, it is necessary to always validate the information of the unknown person who has sent you a friend request. Avoid chatting with any random person on Facebook until the information provided by the person is verified. Misuse or illegal sale of the written literature, software, photos, videos, music, etc. of other by obtaining from internet is called piracy. Electronic media is always misused by sending derogatory messages, spreading vulgar pictures and inflammatory statement. Exchange of information through media like email, Facebook and WhatsApp occur very fast. However, our personal information and phone numbers are automatically spread and thereby reaches the unwanted person, which leads to malpractice like incoming of unnecessary messages. Some of such messages either impair or shut down the mobile and computers. To avoid such unwelcome happening, logging out our account is must. All the above mentioned, these incidents are example of cyber crimes. Committing such crime is also a mental illness. Due to cyber crime, victims suffer from lot of mental stress. To overcome all this, police department has newly launched a cybercrime unit. Cybercrime experts collect the details, investigate the cybercrime and thereby find the criminal with the help of internet. After doing the detailed study of various factors distributing the social health, let us now proceed to the last part of the lesson, that is stress management. Have you seen a loud laughing citizen in morning in public gardens? Name of this newly popularized concept is laughter club. These people relieve their mental stress by laughing loudly. Various ways of expressions like establishing communication with friend, peer, cousins, teachers, and more importantly, parents. Help us to relieve the stress. In the similar manner, noting down our feelings, expressing our feelings without near and dear ones. Laughing also helps to relieve stress. Fostering the hobbies like material collection, photography, reading, cooking, sculpturing, drawing, rangoli, dancing, etc. helps us to properly utilize the free hour by diverting the enough energy and mind towards the positive thinking. Negative thoughts are automatically neutralized. When we are in school, we eagerly wait for the period of music, PT, and drawing. The reason behind this is that learning and listening to the music, singing, keeping us happy and drives away the stress. Music has the power of changing the mindset. Importance of outdoor games is unparalleled. There are various benefits of sports, like it causes physical exercises, improves discipline, interaction, and tendency of unity. Loneliness is driven away and person becomes more social. Regular exercising, massaging, visiting the spa to help to relieve the stress. Yoga is not limited to asanas and pranayam, but it includes discipline, balanced and good food, and meditation also. Deep breathing, yogic sleep, yogasan, etc. are good for health. Today, due to our impatient and eager of achieving things instantly, we have lost peace and concentration of our mind. Meditation helps to improve the ability of concentration. It imparts positivity in our concentration. Meditation helps the student to improve concentration in their studies. Deliberately inculcation of habits like time management, planning of our own duties and decisions. Power is nothing but cultivating the social, strong and ideal personality. We have all the ways to manage our stress. However, if those are not successful due to certain reason, it leads to some more serious problems like depression and frustration. Medical advice, counseling and physiotherapy are available for such person. Similarly, many NGOs also provide helping hand. Let us see the information about some of these people. First one, Unified Movement Against Tobacco. This movement has been started by 45 different well-known organizations like WHO, Tata Trust, etc. This movement is active for controlling the tobacco consumption and providing guidance to activists against tobacco. Second, Salaam Mumbai Foundation. This organization runs program in various schools in Mumbai to empower the children living in slum area in the field of education, sports, arts and businesses. This organization encourages the children to take education by helping them to improve their health and lifestyle. This trust has made some districts in Maharashtra completely tobacco free. This program is being implemented with the help of government in about 200 schools in Mumbai and 14,000 schools in the rest of Maharashtra. As per the government letter, the oath freedom from tobacco is taken in every school. Let us see the next topic, that is government schemes. Government keeps on implementing in various schemes such as an effort to maintain social health, helpline numbers are published in newspaper to help the children in distress or facing any type of problems. Children can contact these helpline numbers to narrate their problems. Proper help and guidelines are offered to children. Here the lesson is finished. So today we have studied social health, factors affecting social health and stress management. Hope you all understood the topic. Thank you. Stay home, stay safe.